Hello students, I Neela ma'am here from SKM Public School. Today I am going to teach you chapter number 3, playing with numbers. I have selected worksheet number 17. Based on my previous videos, here there are some fill in the blanks, some questions based on factors, multiples, perfect numbers. So I think you have watched my previous videos based on chapter number 3, playing with numbers. So I think you have watched those videos. If you haven't watched, you can watch. Only then you will learn about factor, multiples, perfect number, twin primes, composite numbers, prime numbers. So let's start today. Filling the blanks. First, an exact divisor of a number is called a factor of the number. We call that factor. So 1 is a factor of every number. Which number is factor of every number? 1 is factor of every number. 1 can divide each and every number exactly. Exactly mean to say ki when you divide any number by 1, the remainder when you will get as 0, means you are, 1 is dividing the particular number exactly. A number is a multiple of each of its factor, and every number is multiple of each of its factor. The number of multiples of a given numbers is infinite. When we write table, don't think it ends at 10. 7 tens are 70, like that. So multiples are many. Infinite multiples are there of a given number. 7 elevens are 2. You can continue it. 7 hundreds are, 7 thousands are. So number of multiples of the given number is infinite. Every number is a multiple as well as a factor of itself. Every number is multiple as well as factor of itself. A number for which sum of all its factors is equal to twice the number is called a perfect number. Suppose we take example of 6. Factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3, 6. All these numbers 1, 2, 3, 6 divide 6 exactly. So these will become factors of 6. When we will add all these factors of 6, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6, we get 12. So 12 is 2 times 6, 2 times the given number, which factors we have written 1, 2, 3 and 6. When I have added all these factors, its total is 12. So 12 is 2 times 6. So a number for which sum of its factors is equal to twice the number will be called perfect number. Number of factors of a given number is finite. Multiples are infinite, but factors are finite. Finite means limiting. 9 is a factor of 36. If you are given that 7 8s are 56, then 7 becomes factor of 56. 56 is multiple of 7. 8 is also factor of 56. But 56 is multiple of 8. Here, distinguish between multiples and factors. Then find the factors of the following numbers. Factors of 45 are, factors are the number which divides the given number exactly. So 1 can divide 45 exactly, 3 can also divide 45 exactly, 5 also, 5 nines are 45, 9 can also divide 45 exactly, 15 also, 15 threes are 45, 45 will also divide itself. So factors of 45 are 1, 3, 5, 9, 15 and 45. Then factors of 64, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. All these numbers can divide 64 exactly. So these numbers 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64 will be called factors of 64. Then 78. 78, I have taught you one of the method here. You can use this method also. Factors of, here factors of 78, like that. 178 is 78. Then 239 is 78. Then 76 are 78. Then after 3, so 78 not in the table of 4, not in the table of 5, it is in the table of 6 also. So 6, 13s are 78, then not in the table of 7, not divisible by 8, not divisible by 9, not divisible by 10, 11, 12, it is divisible by 13. So 13 is already with us. So factors of 78 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 13, 26, 39 and 78. In this way you will find factors of 78 by this method also, or you can think of the number which can be divisible by 78 exactly. Then comes multiples of. Write all the multiples of 13 between 26 and 117. So you can't start with 26 because we are asked to write all the multiples of 13 between 26 and 117. So 13 2 ja 26, we will not take that. 13 3 ja 39, 13 4 ja 52, 13 5 ja 65, 13 6 ja 78, 13 7 ja 91, 13 8 ja 104. We have to, after that it will be greater than 117. So we will stop at 104. Then multiples, write all the multiples of 17 between 51 and 136. So we will not take 17 2s are, 73s are, 17 3s are, and we will take 17 4s are 68, 17 5s are 85, 17 6s are 102, 17 7s are 119, and we will stop at this because after that we will get the number greater than 136. Then I have also taught you about perfect number. When perfect number is the number when sum of all its factors is equal to twice the number, are called perfect numbers. So we are going to show here ki 28 is a perfect number. For that we need factors. We will find all the factors of 28. So factors of 28 are 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, 28. All these are factors because all these number, 1 can divide 28 exactly, 2 can divide 28 exactly, 4 can also divide 28 exactly, 7 also can divide 28 exactly. 14 also can divide 28 exactly, and 28 itself can divide 28. So, sum of all the factors of 28 are 1 plus 2 plus 4. We are adding all these factors, okay? 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 14 plus 28. So, after adding all these numbers, we are getting 56. Now, this 56 is twice of 28, the given number 28. So, the sum of all the factors is equal to now twice the number 28. So, when a number for which sum of all its factors is equal to the number will be called perfect number. The number will be called perfect number. So this is worksheet number 17. Worksheet number 18. This is also based on previous videos. Those who haven't watched those videos can watch and try to solve worksheet number 18 based on prime, composite, even, odd numbers and also twin prime numbers also. Twin prime numbers. This is for you. You will solve these based on prime numbers, composite numbers and even odd numbers and twin primes. Twin primes, okay? So, worksheet number 18. This is homework. Chapter number 3. Playing with numbers. Till then, stay alert, stay healthy, mask yourself, take proper care. Thank you. And try to revise chapter number 1 of both books for pre-midterm exams. Thank you.